Dire's structures are fortified.
He's able to pick up the haste rune as well, so... Again, Zephyr, he makes the rotation to just secure that, and he's just going to go straight back to the jungle, even spot out some of these stacks, so... Real nice.
Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant are scanning.
He's just playing around these bounty rune areas, maybe popping the hex a little bit too soon. It's Zephyr. I'm not sure what you're doing there, buddy.
First blood. I'm by right, as well as
my
bring out to him the Null Talisman recipe, so he's got double. Maybe buy up the boots next.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Extra little movement speed to get them a little bit better. I think they've got attack animation with it as well. It could be real nice.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Down on this bottom side on Dire? No, they don't, so... Even though they've got these three heroes here, they included, they didn't actually make an attempt to try and kill Ame, which is a little surprising to me.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Here I am!
I mean, he's doing totally fine. Like, it's one of those matchups where you really just do not care. You're doing enough damage.
Radiant's middle
even
tower
all those
is under
stacks
attack.
Don't mean much for anything. He's getting chased up. He's level 3 now, not stuck at level 1, but I don't think that's going to save you when you're silenced up underneath your tower. Maybe it could, though. Just get far enough back. The other thing I was about to say is that, like, with the heroes that they've gone in terms of the alchemists, they're not really in a position to try and make that kind of aggressive play. But if you're T1 and you're literally diving the tier 2 tower when the tier 1 is still up, you can make that kind of play to ruin them. Yeah, pal. Pick up the arcane rune, they go on top.
That's the formula!
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
He's just dancing around, though. He doesn't care. He's living his life.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
God is spoken.
No, I would say... Oh, it's so hard to say, right? Because it enables you to farm so much more effectively if you've got it on the monkey, but your team fight is so much stronger if you've got it on the Zeus, so it depends what their priority is. And I think it's going to depend on really what happens between now and the end. Is 23 Savage pulled out in a few crappy positions?
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Even just the cogs, you know?
Dire's courier has been killed. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Oh, yeah. At least they're on different teams this time. The game that T1 played where they picked both of them. No. Rotation through the top side. Didn't even need to have any sort of rune bottle. It was actually the Zeus that had the illusion rune available, so that was just all Carl, baby.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
He heard you.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified.
Even Innocence just down here, you know, he's clearing out waves. You've got your siege creep here. I wonder if he might even, you know, tank up a few hits to make sure that Hardy's not going to die. No, he's just going to let it die like an absolute
fiend. Dire's structures are fortified.
Coming in.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I mean, he basically got it with his ancient stack, so I would say no. I think you need to be doing a lot more against
Radiant's
the Nalcimus,
middle tower
even if it
is
in a cruel position. It's super vulnerable.
Dire's
no
top tower is under attack.
He's just got full greed and not being punished. And he gives it over the monk. I think that's
Dire's
perfect.
Top tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Dire's top tower is under attack.
If you aren't doing a taking a page from them, we're just like, oh, you can't find them. Well,
Dire's top tower.
Jack, thanks you very much.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Invisibility.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Just to make sure that, you know, when he's making me And you're not afraid at all now that the puck is dead for the next 20 seconds. So you could just see instantly retreating back to the jungle. Not need to care too much about the
jungle.
That's not the main priority. The main priority is... Let's see, Alpha's just building up that second axe center. Based on how well this early game has gone, they haven't been punished too heavily. You know what? I can sit back and do more. You want to have an Enigma with a Blink Dagger early on? Well, I can respond with a Nimbus so that you can cancel it out at any position on the map. He's got more of those points into the Grievous Greed as well. You can see that he's got a lot more of an impact. Nice and balanced having all of this net worth on the market king through the alchemist, but it only happens as a result of T1 not effectively punishing them, right? They're combating slow with slow, they're thinking, well, our strategy is going to win, but not as of yet.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Sure, but what are you actually going to get with that? Like, for me, it's not like it opens up Roshan, right? Like, on this lineup, you don't really have anyone that quickly
Dire's
takes
Roshan.
Abandoned Weave is kind of nice,
top
but
tower is under
it's
attack.
Nothing near the scale of Monkey King with Axe Thread. And even the stuff
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Nothing to say back a little bit, you know, against the puck he wanted to... So he was building into the Yule Scepter, but he switched
attack.
That up, he's going straight for the Refresher up, taking a leaf from GH's book, and... I mean, if you can get that Super Element, I don't even know if you'll have the mana pool to be able to cast two full sets of spells if you're just using an Axe Scepter that was gifted to you. Situations where it's like, look, if we get the pick off, fantastic. If not, it's our position 5 and taking it to nothing. So, I think you can just see, even though it's the position 1 and he's taking some of the quote unquote easier camps, it's just about making space for this out. He is on the other side of the map. He is TPing top bot, every single time.
Thank you.
They're attempting this Roche with just two, but not gonna happen. Just take back the outpost. Valuable experience going T1's way again. You'd have to say that's a pretty decent reveal, being able to kill off Barev again on one of his more favorite heroes. He's died now 3 times. He's got a decent amount of farm, honestly, but it just feels a little scattered. You know, he's got a hood, finger sand, and a plate mail right now, so.
Strange. Transformation.
Who the other guys?
Thanks, God. Nethershawl ends up killing him with the minus armor. I think the big thing that they're waiting for right now is this Enigma to have the BKB. BKB Black Hole, of course, can change around anything, and they're gonna want it to be in a congested team fight, so there's no easy angle hook to come through to this run. Alchemist's gifting days are done. It's all about
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Right now, face the island. Radiant's structures are looking to give them that little bit of extra teamfight initiation. You've got the clockwork of course, but we've seen a number of times we've got to out here again.
Radiant's top tower
has
fallen.
This
changes Radiant's to reflect for
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
All the while I'm in just pushing this top down, and these golden monkeys whacking away.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Haste.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Fuck again. Oh, he's so good.
is under attack.
Now he knows how Miracle felt.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
A golden thread.
Dire are scanning.
I could do with more than that.
Places either in their own jungle or just a bit of a lane ward, which feels a little.
Dire's bottom tower has
sort of belated. Post mature, not premature. I think you could honestly benefit from just having a little bit of extra movement speed just from a casual wind lace or something like that, just because you're lacking the flick dagger right now. You're going camping in a few days, aren't you? Standing right on top of the monkey king before. I'm not sure what reason, and it just meant that that hook shot hits it onto multiple. He gets the stun off. It enables the monkey to get that burst needed to be able to take him down before the black hole gets popped. You know, he'd used BKB, hookshots used, there's literally Radiant's no other way to interrupt a BKB black hole, and he was just standing way too...
Coming in!
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Excuse me. Absolutely.
Radiant's top tower is on pause. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. Radiant's bottom barracks are under attack. Radiant's bottom barracks has fallen. Radiant's bottom barracks has fallen. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
They'll probably take the tier 2. We still got the Aegis 1.5 minutes. That's how fast paid LGD has been so far.
Radiant's middle tower
has fallen. We should wait until they cool down. They've got a refresher on the battle again. If you give him any window to get out of that, he will. But they've just been able to combo him down every single time. And now, well, what's up we've got for himself? He's Got a Ag Scepter. And he gives it over to GQ. Why not? You know? He's an absolute beast. We said last time was the final
Radiant
attempt. Maybe this is the final attempt.
Jackpot!
I'm just saying.
Radiant's top barracks are under attack. Radiant's top barracks has fallen.
You give them an inch, they're gonna attack every single.
Radiant's structures are fortified. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's top barracks has fallen. Radiant's middle barracks are under attack. Radiant's middle barracks has fallen. Dire now has
the victory. Explain a way to get back into this, but you gotta land a BKB blink black hole. You gotta land a black hole of any sort. You know, it just feels like it's black hole. Well, I've been caught out multiple times. I've nothing to say, but it's gonna be enough.
We've got pretty good chemistry.
Not what you expected.
Yeah, it's probably because they're having to deal with all these lanes constantly pushing in, so even if they, you know, get a black hole, it's gonna be another 60 seconds until they actually look to try and reach any kind of balance on the LGD side. They can wait, but why? Why?